Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is your brother Bilal, inshallah, with a Ramadan reflection, reflecting on recitation and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, today I would like to share three beautiful, powerful reflections of when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam first received revelation. So it's mentioned that he would take these retreats and seclude himself from society in this cave. So one thing that we can take from this is that, alhamdulillah, one of the blessings of what's going on right now is we have an opportunity in seclusion to redefine our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to really ponder about society and what's going on. And this is one of the blessings about seclusion and maybe going on retreats, this idea of just being by yourself. It's something that's very remarkable, because you rediscover yourself. You can rediscover your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing that I would like to share with you is when he sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in the cave all alone, he feels this presence that squeezes him to the point he couldn't breathe no more. And the presence says, "Iqra, read." And in that moment, you see, you and I would react in a manner that would be maybe in a moment of, get out of here, you know, who is this, and fight back. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even though in the moments of distress and fearfulness, he was honest and showed mercy by simply answering, "I cannot read." And this goes on two more instances where finally Jibril recites to him, "Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq," read in the name of your Lord. The third and last point that I would like to share is, after this happens, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam runs down this mountain and into the arms of Khadija, his wife. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her. So he sallallahu alayhi wasallam finds comfort in his spouse. You see, you and I, when we come home off a long stressful day, the last person that we want to talk to is our spouse about our problems. We find in this situation that he sallallahu alayhi wasallam rushes to his spouse, and not only does she covers him as he instructs her to do so, but she offers support and kind words. So an action item, inshallah, is to listen to our spouses when they come to us venting, or when they come to us in moments of distress. They need you to be there for them. So don't react right away. Rather, listen and offer kind words of comfort. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to have a deeper understanding. Jazakallahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.